The functional assessment-based intervention model employs a systematic approach to designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based procedures developed by Embright, Farrow, Leopsin, and Lane, 2007. In previous videos, we introduced you to this five-step process by beginning in step one, identifying students who need a FABI, and step two, conducting the functional assessment, where we discussed how to discover the function of the behavior, that is, the reasons why the behaviors occur. This video introduced you to step three, collecting baseline data. In step three, teams collect baseline data. In single case design, baseline serves as a control condition to compare against other conditions in which a specific instruction or treatment of interest is introduced. For this, it is important to measure present levels of responding. We call this baseline. This step begins with identifying the behavior of interest. Remember, in functional assessment-based interventions, there are at least two behaviors of interest, the target and replacement behavior, which were operationally defined during step two, conducting the functional assessment. Behaviors measured during baseline and subsequent steps of the FABI process are often the replacement behavior, as they examine and monitor a desired change, which allows conversations regarding the student's progress to be focused on the positive behavior. There are many different dimensions of behavior that can be measured, such as frequency or duration. As such, there are also different measurement systems that should be aligned to the behavior dimension. For example, let's say I was interested in the amount of time a child spent wandering around the room. Frequency recording, where I measure how often this occurs, would not be ideal, as it would not tell me how long the behavior lasted, only how many times. Imagine one day the child is out of his chair one time for 60 minutes. And another day, the child is out of his chair 10 times, but for under 30 seconds each time. Duration per occurrence would be a good measurement system here, as would interval recording, such as partial interval recording or momentary time sampling. To learn more about these and other measurement systems, see our video on behavior dimension and measurement systems. When a measurement system has been identified and is aligned to the behavior of interest, teams formalize their data collection procedures. This includes gathering or making materials needed, such as data collection sheets or timing forms, and scheduling observation times. In single case designs, which we will employ in the FABI process, it is important we follow the logic of time series analysis. That is, we need to record the behavior around the same time and same setting. It is often important to decide who will be the data collectors and to assign at least two roles, primary and secondary data collector. Primary and secondary data collectors are then trained to reliability and practice to criterion to ensure confidence in the data collected and clarity of the behavior measured. For example, prior to baseline data, two observers might go into the classroom and observe the same behavior during 10 to 15 minute observations until they achieve 90% agreement over three consecutive trials as calculated by inter-observer agreement. This promotes confidence in the accuracy of the data collected and clarity of the behavior measured, which is why operational definitions of behavior are important. Once the individuals collecting data are trained to criteria and reliable, baseline data collection can begin. We recommend the primary observer collect baseline data for approximately 5 observations with a minimum of 3 observations. The secondary observer independently observes and collects data at the same time as the primary observer for 25% of observations during each phase for each student and or each target behavior. From there, inter-observer agreement is calculated. Inter-observer agreement for frequency recording, for example, can be calculated by dividing the lesser total by the greater total and multiplying by 100. In this example, we see two observers record frequency of peer initiations in a 30-minute observation window. The primary observer recorded 10 instances, which equates to a peer initiation rate of 0.33 times per minute, whereas the secondary observer recorded 8 instances of this behavior in a rate of 0.27 per minute. If we divided the lesser total 8 by the greater total 10 and multiply by 100, we have an 80% inter-observer agreement. If baseline data indicate current levels of behavior support the need of the intervention and data are somewhat predictable in their pattern, then it may be time to introduce the intervention. In step 4, we will learn about designing the intervention, and in step 5, we will learn about testing the intervention. To learn more about this process, you may watch our video on behavioral data collection. You may also review Applied Behavior Analysis, second edition by Cooper, Heron, and Heward, 2007, and Functional Behavior Assessment and Function-Based Intervention, an effective practical approach by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsin, and Lane, 2007.